Okay, so this is probably Birmingham part two. So we've done the Birmingham challenges. Go and have a look at the video if you want to. And this is now looking at a specific piece of urban regeneration, Longbridge Urban Regeneration. What does your spec want? An urban generation project, the Longbridge Regeneration Project, to show the reasons why the area needed regeneration and the main features of the project. One slide does it all. So Longbridge down here was a very, very, very large car factory, really famous, and around it you have various other factories that fed it, such as Dunlop Tyres, which I have to confess my father used to work at, and other places that provided components, so Lucas Industrial, all kinds of things. So 100 years of car making, good times. 1965, 340,000 cars were built there, blah, blah, blah. Local and regional multiply effect. That's the most important. Car factories employ lots of people, but they also employ lots of people in other industries around them that supply the components. However, due to overseas competition, cars being made cheaper in new manufacturing sites, particularly coastal sites where they can import and export the raw materials and the products, Longbridge essentially became unworkable, uneconomic, and it was closed in 2005. That meant a very large area near the centre of Birmingham became derelict, meaning it wasn't used anymore. Vandals got in, urban cool kids got in, drug takers got in, the usual malarkey. You may have watched Peaky Blinders. Well, actually, it's a bit later than Peaky Blinders, but you get the idea. Spiral of decline, negative multiplier, spiral decline, no jobs, local people don't have money to spend, local services like news agents don't keep going, they close, less attractive, blah, blah, blah. So a good old brownfield site, typical D, or sorry, decline of manufacturing, what we call de-industrialization, de-industrialization. So that brownfield site then had to be renovated in some way. So what they've done is they've taken the brownfield site, they've added in housing, 2,000 homes to support the local people, social and local multiplier effect. 1,000 new jobs have been put in there, and you can see some examples, which I do suggest you get. Some in blue are service, some in green are employment, some in yellow are shops, you can see from there. £70 million town centre made in Longbridge, and then a technology park, of course, replacing the old dead manufacturing with brand new, spanking, highly skilled industrial jobs. The problem is, of course, the same people used to put tires on cars aren't the same skills required for people who are going to do robotics and AI and programming in tech parks. So you've got a dislocation of the people from their jobs. So although it's not all bad or not all good, you've got to try and think of the positives and the negatives. And also, because of its location links, you know that Birmingham is the centre of the universe for the motorways network of Britain, big distribution centre, again employing people, a local multiplier effect. This, of course, because it's a brownfield site in Birmingham, has reduced pressure on the outskirts, so less green belt pressure, which gives you an environmental tick. Okay, the problems that are still there. Housing prices may go up because people working in these areas can outbid the people working who no longer have jobs, of course. And of course, you may get congestion because people will move in, and there's a lot of commuting. Sorry, there's a lot of evidence of the growth of commuter settlements and people taking advantage of moving in. However, if I just use my father for an example, my father used to drive in 20 miles anyway, way back throughout the 60s and 70s. So it's not a new problem. That's it. You might find some more case studies you find useful. Over and out.